While I am home for the holidays, I decided to work on a project that was small in scale but fun nevertheless. I'm going to use my Ender 3 3D printer as a 2D pen plotter. I'll use one of these 0.3mm felt tip pens as the tool for drawing. I took a loose measurement of the pen's width for later. I found a printable attachment for the Ender 3 that would allow me to modify the parameters for my pen. The link to this model will be in the description. I used the included OpenSCAD file to set the tool diameter to 10mm. Next, I printed the attachment. After some melting and messing up, I got a captive nut and M3 screw to hold the pen in place. I used a piece of electrical tape and a strategically placed zip tie to hold the attachment to the tool head of the printer. The pen was a little too loose, so I just stuck a pen cap next to it as a shim. Now I had to see what Z height the pen tip was from the bed, as well as what X and Y position it was offset from the normal extruder printhead. This means that when I want to draw something, I need the height of the extruder to be 11mm higher than normal. In the Cura slicing software, I changed my machine settings to turn off the heated bed. I changed my nozzle size to 0.3mm, the same size as my pen. I did the same for wall thickness. I set my wall count to 2 as I prefer the thicker outline. In order for the lines to stay on one level, I set the top to bottom thickness at 0mm. I chose a 60% lines infill, which, depending on the size of the graphic, will fill in the black areas. The extruder will not heat up when I set the material temperature to 0. I enabled the retraction setting so that the Z-hop could be enabled. The Z offset setting is not a part of Cura by default. I had to install a plugin from the marketplace called Z offset setting. I then set it to 11mm. I imported an STL file that I converted from an SVG of the Hackbatch logo. I will leave a link to the online tool used to do this below. I used the offsets I measured earlier to shift the print so that it was aligned to where the pen would actually draw in the center of the page. The final step is to scale the print so that it is only one layer. I did this by turning off uniform scaling and adjusting the Z scale until it could slice the model and get an estimated print time. If I could not get a print preview and estimated time, the print would fail in my testing. While it took a little bit of moving things around to get the results I wanted, it only took about 3 tries to get something that looks this cool. I'm very happy with how such a simple hack turned out. I'm looking forward to doing more plotter projects with this in the future. Thanks for watching, everyone. Stay tuned to hackbatch.com for more projects like this.